moving on to our player tip of the podcast. Don't be a dick.
Almost.
Would you like, Garwin, would you like to tell us about our player tip of the podcast, the Juggernaut Cleric?
I'd actually rather like this idea. This build is really straightforward. Choose the Warforged race from Eberron Rising from the last war. It gives you a +1 integrated protection. Then pick up Chainmail Armor, base 16 AC, and Shield for an extra +2. Now you have a total of 19 AC, and that's without a class. Ooh. The class that makes the build work the best is Cleric of the Forge from Xanathar's Guide. It allows the cleric to bless a piece of armor, giving it a +1 extra AC. Then taking the spell Shield. Shield of Faith will give you more, +2 AC. There's some spelling errors in there. Your 22 AC first level character is wading into hordes of goblins who only have a 10% chance to hit you. This build is considered legal and shouldn't have too many issues at the table, unless you're the DM.
Yeah, actually, that build only with a dwarf, and it was kind of hilarious in the very first fight to go, well, have the DM go, does a 20 hit you? Expecting it to be yes. I'm like, no. Wait, what?
So there, I've done tips about the fact that armor class isn't the end all be all, but I felt like this needed love.
Yep.
Because AC, you know, doesn't help you when you get kicked off a mountaintop. But in the meantime, against hordes of enemies, it absolutely does. And the cleric is best for this because they've got so many spells that let them, you know, attack enemies all around them. So it just seems like a juggernaut cleric is exactly what the game called for.
Yeah. Probably the best part about this is that, you know, you only start with chainmail, yes, but it's your starting equipment. You're going to increase that eventually, you know, from a 16 plus all of that to an 18 plus all of that. Because a Forge Cleric has proficiency with heavy armor.
Yes, it does.
Yep. And the best, and probably the best part about on top of all that, you're a cleric. You don't have to be a melee fighter.
No. And the Forge Domain Cleric can make his own plate mail if he wants to. Dang it.
Absolutely, which is awesome.
You don't even have to spend $1,500.
This is certainly a fun concept. You can really have a lot of fun when it comes to clerics just because of the versatility. But giving one such a high AC as the tank and taking up utility abilities to help your allies, you literally can make it so that you are the center of attention. You are drawn, which means the wizard, the sorcerer, the warlock, all the squishies don't got to worry about it.
Yeah.
And it's much easier for a rogue to get sneak attack when you're literally surrounded by the enemy.
Oh, yeah.
Run up behind him and stab him in the ass. So,
like, I will also admit, it's a great flavor opportunity. Like, you're a warforged. Mm-hmm. Like, yes, using blessing one or two on you better your armor. But you can flavor that as you're tweaking with your now integrated protection. Because remember, the armor isn't, you don't put the armor on. You integrate it into yourself as a Warforged. It becomes your new body.
Nice. I love it. This is one of my favorite races for a lot of reasons. But the flavor that comes out of it is just fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
All right. That'll do it for our player tip of the podcast.